All officials in Thailand inspect voting materials in Bangkok ahead of general elections on Sunday. The polls come early, a decade of government rule led or backed by the military. Some 52 million eligible voters in Southeast Asia's second largest economy are expected to flock to polling stations. Former Army Chief Prime Minister Prayut Chan-o-cha, who swept to power after a 2014 coup, is going against an opposition led by a party backed by the billionaire Shinawat family. Elon Musk has made his pick for his replacement as Twitter CEO, and the rumors were true. The tech billionaire has chosen top ad executive Linda Yaccarino. Yaccarino stepped down from NBC Universal, effective immediately on Friday following the reports. Musk's move is said to allay the growing concerns of Tesla investors on the time that Musk is devoting to turning around Twitter. Philippine officials heading to Kuwait next week to discuss an entry ban imposed on Filipinos without residency permits. The delegation will be composed of officials from the Departments of Migrant Workers and Foreign Affairs. They will clarify a supposed violation committed by the Philippine government in its labor agreement with Kuwait.
Merong tayong impormasyon na kailangan pong meron pong napipintong pag-uusap sa susunod na linggo ang magbigay ng daan sa labor diplomacy na tinatawag pag-uusap sa pagitan ng pamahalang Pilipinas at pamahalang Kuwait. May delegation po, combined delegation, pool of government approach, DFA at ang DMW magtutungo sa Kuwait. Kasi kailangan natin din klaruhin ano yung rationale, ano yung dahilan, ano yung mga issues na bumabalot dito sa suspension. At para malaman din natin kung ano ang mga posibleng solusyon, magbibigay daan ano, sa pakikipag-usap, pagkaklaro, at sabay nito, solusyon para magkaroon ng positibo tayong pagtugon at solusyon dito sa mga issues.
According to estimates of local recruitment agencies, some 3,000 Filipinos are affected by the ban. Government vows to provide assistance.
Of course, ang mahalagang direktiba ni Secretary Tuts Ople ay tulungan yung mga apektado at yung mga posibleng maapektuhan itong pagpataw ng suspension. So, nakabobilize po ang National Reintegration Center na nasa ilalim ng Department of Migrant Workers at ang Overseas Workers Welfare Administration under Administrator Arnel Ignacio, nakahanda pong tumulong at meron na nga pong natutulungan tayo sa kasalukuyan.
Kuwait announced the sweeping entry ban on Wednesday. Six Filipino human trafficking victims rescued in Myanmar have returned home. Now, this is the latest batch of repatriated Filipinos who were lured online with the promise of employment in Thailand, only to work at a Chinese cryptocurrency scam in Myanmar. Some of the victims were allegedly tortured if they weren't able to make a profit. They were also forced to pay up to 300,000 pesos to gain their freedom.
Nung una po talaga, pagdating namin doon, nagba-back out na po agad kami. Kaso po, sinisingil po kami nung una ng 3,000 US dollar, USDT. Eh wala naman po kaming ganung kalaking pera. Paglapag namin ng Bangkok, ang sabi, kasikasuhin daw po yung working visa namin. Nung nakapag-cross namin ng river, doon na lang din po namin nalaman na nasa Myanmar na din po kami.
Nung nagtatanong na po sila na kailangan na pong magpadala ng pamilya ng pera, sa akin pong side kasi wala nga pong naipadala, konti lamang po. So kada ano po, nung una po, unang araw, napalo na po ako ng tubo sa ulo, sa iba't ibang parte ng katawan at saka sa likod ko po sa may puwitan po.
Some 60 more Filipino human trafficking victims remain in Myanmar according to the Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission. Philippine officials are now coordinating with authorities of concerned countries to crack down on these scammers. The Philippine Migrant Workers Department teams up with the Foreign Affairs Department to rescue more Filipinos who fled conflict-torn Sudan. The DMW says a composite team between the two agencies is now on its way to Port Sudan to help around 100 Filipinos there reach safe ground in Saudi Arabia. The agency is calling on Filipinos who remain in the war-torn country to evacuate. The government earlier said at least 50 Filipinos remain in Sudan, while hundreds have returned to the Philippines.
Patuloy ang panawagan ng ating pamahalaan na sila'y lumikas na kasi ito ay issue ng safety and security. Hindi po ito ang panahon, hindi ito ang panahon na pag-isipan ang mga ilang bagay pa na hindi nasasangkot ang safety and security. Kaligtasan po ng buhay ang usapan, kaya nananawagan po tayo sa mga naroroon pa sa Khartoum, sa Sudan, na lumikas na ho dahil nakahanda pong tumulong ang inyong pamahalaan.
Another attempt at a truce in Sudan fails as airstrikes and artillery pounded the capital Khartoum Friday. Despite committing to protect civilians and allow humanitarian access, Sudan's forces and the paramilitary group RSF have shown little sign they are already ready to end the deadly fighting. But a Sudanese envoy says it isn't the Sudan army that's launching offensives.
The Sudanese armed forces are not launching an offensive. They are actually making a defensive. This is why they will not open fire only if they have been attacked. And this is why from time to time there will be a kind of what apparently may be as a breach of the ceasefire. But actually this is not meant. And this is actually not the case which is currently being on. There is a kind of trying to operationalize the center of the town. And as much as those rebellious regiments who took refuge into heavily inhabited areas and they confiscated houses, they are there. And this is why the army would not attack them, definitely, in order to lessen the loss of civilians. This is our principal commitment, actually, and we are abiding by it.
A so-called declaration of principles was signed in Saudi Arabia late on Thursday after nearly a week of talks between the warring factions. This is seen as the first step to the start of negotiations to end the fighting. Back here at home, after four straight weeks of rollbacks, pump prices are heading higher next week. Estimates show diesel prices may see the biggest hike of up to 1 peso and 50 centavos per liter. Meanwhile, kerosene prices may go up by 1 peso and 40 centavos per liter and gasoline by around 50 centavos per liter. A leading cybersecurity firm stresses the need for more measures to secure e-wallet services in the Philippines. Kaspersky's call comes after GCash users found unauthorized withdrawals from their accounts early this week. Kaspersky's also believe protecting personal data is a shared responsibility.
Certain security posture must be there to make sure they protect the data and also stop and prevent any attacks on their infrastructure. E-wallet is about digital inclusion. It's about improving with time. It's the responsibility of everyone. I mean, we have to catch up with technology. We have to catch up so that we continue to stay relevant.
The Marcos administration is working double time to minimize the effects of the El Nino phenomenon. That's according to the palace, which shared details of a report from Defense OIC Carlito Galvez Jr. The report said an El Nino team was reconstituted to implement measures to mitigate the weather phenomenon's impact on the country's economy, environment, as well as peace and order. The team will be led by the Interior Department. Marcos last month ordered the creation of the El Nino team after State Weather Bureau Pagasa said the country could be hit by the dry spell as early as next month. The Philippine Agriculture Department also assuring the public there's enough rice supply as the threat of El Nino looms. The agency says measures are in place to mitigate the effects of the dry spell on food production. It also notes some areas produce high yields of unhusked rice even during El Nino. The agency is now conducting assessment of areas that could be negatively or positively affected by the dry spell.